What happened to the Drifters?
Starting in 1950, McFadden was the lead tenor with Billy Ward and his Dominoes for 3 years. The group's success was largely due to McFadden's high-pitched tenor. Ahmet Ertegun realized that this combination did not work during a four-song recording session on June 29, 1953. After Ferbey was involved in an accident and left the group, there were more lineup changes to come. This is the second session in which they record Money Honey, their first major hit. Such a Night was released in November 1953, followed by Honey Love in June 1954, Biff Bam in October 1954, White Christmas in November 1954, and What You Gonna Do in February 1955. McFadden was drafted in March 1954, but because he was stationed in Buffalo, New York at the time, he was able to stay with the group for a while. McFadden's final official record as a member of the Drifters was What You Gonna Do, which was recorded a year before its release, while his first solo release, Everyone's Laughing, came from his final Drifter session in October 1954. McFadden pursued a profitable but relatively short-lived solo career with 16 R&B and 21 pop hits. McFadden requested a big percentage of the group's income, something he had been refused in the Dominoes. Yet when he left, he did not ensure that his successor would receive the same. George Treadwell, manager, former jazz trumpet player, and husband of vocalist Sarah Vaughan, bought his share in the group. As a result, the Drifters recycled a lot of members who did not make much money and were paid only $100 per week. And in 2021, that is $966. McFadden eventually expressed regret for his actions, acknowledging that they put his fellow musicians out of business. Original member David Bunn, who had been singing lead in concert while McFadden was in the Army, was the first to take his place. Although Bunn's voice sounds similar to McFadden's, his unstable conduct made him difficult to work with and unfit in Atlantic Records' view. Bunn soon departed the group to establish the Harps and was replaced by Johnny Moore, who later joined Bill Pinckney's original Drifters in 1958, formerly of the Hornets. This lineup had an R&B success in September 1955, with the A-side Adorable hitting number 1 and the B-side Steamboat reaching number 5. These were followed by Ruby Baby in February 1956 and I Gotta Get Myself a Woman. Members' burnout was exacerbated by low wages. Bill Pinckney was sacked after requesting more money from Treadwell. Andrew Thrasher also quit in protest. The Flyers were created by Pinckney and lead singer Bobby Hendricks, who would leave the following year to join the Drifters. Tommy Evans took over for Pinckney, who had replaced Jimmy Ricks in the Ravens. Andrew Thrasher was replaced by Charlie Hughes, a baritone. With Fools Fall in Love, Moore, Evans, Gerhardt, Thrasher, and Charlie Hughes had a top 10 hit in 1957 in the R&B charts and number 69 in the Hot 100. Bobby Hendricks and Jimmy Millender were drafted to replace Moore and Hughes in 1957. Bobby Hendricks on lead tenor, Gerhardt Thrasher on first tenor, Jimmy Millender on baritone, Tommy Evans on bass, and Jimmy Oliver completed the band by early 1958. In April 1958, this combination had one moderate hit, Drip Drop, which reached number 58 on the Hot 100. The last of the original Drifters were reduced to working the club scene and doing double duty with gigs under the Coasters and Ravens names as their popularity waned. Both Hendricks and Oliver had quit by May 1958, returning only for a week at the Apollo Theater. One of the members got into a confrontation with Ralph Cooper, the master of ceremonies for the Apollo Theater's amateur night during that week. For Treadwell, this was the final straw, and he fired the entire team. Treadwell hired the Five Crowns and dubbed them the Drifters after he argued with Cooper. When Treadwell fired the Drifters, he still controlled the rights to the name Drifters and had a year's worth of bookings at the Apollo. In the summer of 1958, he met Lover Patterson, the manager of the Five Crowns, and arranged for them to become the Drifters, with lead vocalist Benjamin Earl Nelson, better known by a stage name of Benny King. King was on lead tenor, Charlie Thomas on tenor, Doc Green on baritone, and Ellsbury Hobbs made the new lineup. The fifth crown was James Papa Clark, who was left out because of an alcohol issue, which Treadwell has identified as a concern with the first group. The band spent almost a year on the road touring. Because this new band had no ties to the former Drifters, they frequently played to angry crowds. When Atlantic Records decided to record the New Drifters, they contacted Jerry Lieber and Mike Stoller, who had previously worked on the Coasters. The first commercial rock and roll single to use a string orchestra, There Goes My Baby, was a top 10 smash and ranks 193 on the Rolling Stone's 500 Greatest Songs of All Time. Dance With Me came next, followed by This Magic Moment, which reached number 16 on the Hot 100 in 1960. Save the Last Dance for Me hit number 1 in the United States and number 2 in the United Kingdom. Personnel changes occurred as a result of the two-year golden age. George Treadwell and Lever Patterson, the Drifters' tour manager, got into an argument. Patterson refused to let King tour with the group because he was under contract. For approximately a year, King was able to record with the trio. On tour, Johnny Lee Williams and Charlie Thomas handled the vocals, with Johnny Lee Williams singing lead on If You Cry, True Love, True Love, the B-side of Dance With Me. Williams deserted the group when they went through his hometown of Mobile, Alabama. Williams, who was 64 at the time of his death, died on December 19, 2004. King quit because Treadwell refused to give him a salary and a cut of the royalties, and he went on to have a successful solo career. At the same time, Williams quit and Rudy Lewis of the Clara Ward Singers was hired as the new lead. Lewis led the Drifters to such hits as Some Kind of Wonderful, Please Stay, Up on the Roof, On Broadway, and Some Kind of Wonderful, like I previously mentioned. A few of these singles were chart successes, and they were top 10 hits, or even better. And Lewis was also inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as a member of the Drifters when they were inducted. Unfortunately, Benny King passed away on April 30th, 2015 at the age of 76. Hobbs was drafted into the military and was replaced by Tommy Evans, who had returned to the team from the first group. Green left in 1962 and Eugene Pearson took his place of the Rivaliers and the Cleftones. Evans departed once more in 1963 and was replaced by Johnny Terry, a founding member of James Brown's singing group, The Famous Flames, and was co-writer of the first hit, Please, Please, Please. After an unsuccessful solo career and military duty, Johnny Moore rejoined the group in 1964, forming a quintet of Moore, Thomas, Lewis, Pearson, and Perry. The trio was supposed to record Under the Boardwalk on May 21st of that year, but Rudy Lewis died the night before the session, and Johnny Moore took over as the solo lead singer. Lewis and he had been alternating at the time. Terry was replaced for a few months in 1966 by Dan Dandridge, then by William Brent, who had previously played with Johnny Moore and the Hornets in 1954. During the same year, Gene Pearson was replaced by Rick Shepard. William Brent had been replaced by baritone bass Bill Fredericks by late 1966. Charles Baskerville, a former member of the Limelights, replaced Charlie Thomas, the group's last member from the Five Crowns, who left in mid-1967. Baskerville only stayed for a few days. The Drifters left the Atlantic roster in 1972. After performing with him on a tour of the United States in 1959, Bill Pinkney sued the Tears to prevent them from touring as the original Drifters. Benny Anderson, George Wallace, Albert Fortson, and Mark Williams were the Tears. Pinkney's case was successful and obtained exclusive and irreversible ownership of the Drifters' name and mark. Pinkney, Andrew Lawyer, Chuck Cockerham, Harold Jackson, and Tony Cook were the members of the group in 1979. Pinkney, Richard Knight, Dunbar, and Greg Johnson were credited with vocals on their 1995 album Peace in the Valley. Like Sister and Brother, Kissing in the Back Row of the Movies, There Goes My First Love, and You're More Than a Number in My Little Red Book were all hits in the United Kingdom. Shepard and Thomas were replaced by Butch Leek and Grant Kitchings of the Inkspots. The group disbanded in 1986, and Treadwell put together a new lineup with new members Jonah Ellis and old members Ray Lewis, Billy Lewis, and Lewis Price. Johnny Moore, the group's longest-serving member, died on December 30, 1998 in London. Johnny Stewart joined the band in 1963 and left in 1993 to join the Platters in Las Vegas. Faye Treadwell left the United Kingdom in 2001 and abandoned the franchise despite a 1999 jury ruling declaring it abandoned being reversed by a U.S. court. Larry Marjock, the editor of the magazine, organized a series of performances including the Drifters and other legendary vocal groups in 1969. Doc Green, Charlie Thomas, and Ellsbury Hobbs were discovered by him and he began to advertise them as the Drifters. Faye Treadwell, the wife of George Treadwell, the Drifters' manager, took fast legal action. Marjock persuaded Hobbs, Thomas, and Green to apply for a trademark on the Drifters' name in 1976 to give his band exclusive rights to the moniker. The trademark was issued, however, and it was canceled in 2000 in federal court in the United States due to Treadwell's legal action. After that, the original Drifters were divided up into two groups. Between 2005 and 2014, the Truth in Music Advertising Laws was enacted in 34 of the 50 U.S. states to prevent promoters like Marjock from performing with new bands of musicians and promoting them as well-known bands like the Drifters. Tina Treadwell, George and Faye's daughter, served writs at the London High Court in December 2006, saying that Mark Lundquist and Philip Luterman's Drifters UK Ltd. are not the rightful controllers of the Drifters. The Treadwell family and Prism Music Group Ltd. won their legal battle in July 2008. Phil Lederman, Mark Lundquist, Rohan Delano Turney, Peter Lamar, Patrick Allen, and Victor Bynoe were all barred from using the Drifters moniker by a court order. The Treadwell family retains ownership of the Drifters name through Tina Treadwell, George Treadwell's daughter, and the UK-based company Prism Music Group Ltd. The lineup contains Michael Williams, Pierre Harrell, Ryan King, and Carlton Powell. In 2009, the Drifters lineup played in London with special guests the Drifter Legends, which includes some of the group's most illustrious previous members. Neil Martin of Sony Music and songwriter Roger Greenway award Joe Blunt and Butch Leek with Lifetime Achievement Awards at this concert. Butch Leek, Joe Blunt, and Clyde Brown received gold discs from Sony Music in 2012 when they sold 100,000 units sold of Up on the Roof, The Very Best Of. With the exclusion of Johnny Moore, this was the first lineup to have recorded new material on both of the group's previous labels, Atlantic Warner in 2009 and Sony Music in 2011. As of November 2021, the only members of the Drifters that performed on Top 40 Hits that are still alive today are Charles Thomas, or Charlie Thomas. He's still alive and he's currently 84 years old. And the only other member that is still alive that was a part of one of their Billboard Hot 100 songs is Bobby Hendrix. He's 83 years old. And from 1961 to 2008, he was the lead singer of Bill Pinkney's original Drifters. And that's what happened to the Drifters. And it's been well known that the Drifters have had dozens of members over the years. And Rolling Stone even said at one time that the Drifters were the least stable of the great vocal groups. And that's just how it was with a lot of R&B groups back in the 50s and early 60s. Members would go left and right, and there wouldn't be a consistent lineup for most of the big groups. That's what happened to the Drifters. Thank you for watching, like and subscribe if you haven't already, and let me know who should I do next on this YouTube channel. And there's a playlist on screen of my favorite Drifter songs. Give me your favorite Drifter songs. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.